Chairman Gowdy, Ranking Member Cummings, and members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify this morning on how we can ensure the safety and security of our election system. My name is Ricky Hatch, and I am the elected clerk auditor for Weber County, Utah. Today, I'm here on behalf of the National Association of Counties, which represents all 3,069 county governments across the country. In addition to running elections in my county, I serve as a NACO appointee to the Election Assistance Commission Board of Advisors. I am on the Government Coordinating Council for the Election Infrastructure Subsector, and I am the Division Director for Election Officials for the International Association of Government Officials. As elections are the foundation of our democracy, election officials across the country embrace our duty to ensure that our elections are secure, fair, and trustworthy. All elections are local, and I'm here today to underscore the importance of including counties in federal and state discussions to strengthen our national efforts to secure elections, and also to offer suggestions to improve collaboration among all levels of government. Counties play a key role in our nation's election system and work with states to ensure the integrity of the process. In virtually every state, counties run the day-to-day operations of elections. There are almost 9,000 dedicated local election officials like me throughout the country who oversee the allocation of voting machines, manage polling locations, print and mail ballots, recruit and train poll workers, and ensure the integrity of the entire voting process. During the 2016 election, counties of all sizes managed over 100,000 polling locations and hired and trained over 800,000 poll workers. But elections are not just a one-day event for counties. From a cybersecurity standpoint alone, we work year-round to protect against direct hacking attempts that seek to improperly access voter rolls, remove election information from county websites, or alter voting data. We also work to protect voting machines, computers, and other equipment used to cast, record, tally, and certify votes. The integrity of the elections process is our main goal. And security is a key component of that goal. Fortunately, coordination between the federal government and localities has improved dramatically in the past 18 months. These partnerships have been invaluable to help protect us from cybersecurity attacks. And these include the establishment of the Government Coordinating Council by the Department of Homeland Security, which has been open and refreshingly responsive to our frank and frequent feedback during this process. They also include the $380 million in the 2018 omnibus. Many states, including my home state of Utah, are coordinating with their local governments on the best ways to use this funding. Throughout this whole process, the EAC has been the glue in coordinating and promoting all of these new efforts. While all of these are positive changes, we suggest three items to further improve our collective election security efforts. First, we encourage Congress to support a dedicated, predictable federal funding stream to help local governments protect elections. As you can imagine, resources often get stuck at the state level, which can be problematic for those of us on the ground. We upgrade aging equipment and shore up our defenses at great cost to county governments, which often do not have the luxury or ability to increase revenues to offset these costs. While the omnibus funding was helpful, we need more at the local level to combat these cyber threats. Second, we recommend additional coordinated federal and state outreach to local jurisdictions, especially those that are more remote and rural, as Ms. Oliver mentioned in her testimony. For a variety of reasons, such as limited staff, only a small percentage of local election officials are accessing the valuable free technical resources provided by our federal partners. We urge our federal and state partners to help us reach these jurisdictions. And finally, Congress and federal agencies should undertake a robust federalism consultation process with states and local governments when considering any changes to election cybersecurity protocols. Local election officials have the most complete understanding of the elections process, and we want to share that understanding with lawmakers to help ensure that any federal legislation or programs are fully effective on the ground. Ultimately, the best way to safeguard our elections and shore up our cyber defenses is to communicate and work together. We stand ready to work with you, with federal agencies, and with our states to strengthen our nation's elections process and retain the public's confidence. Chairman Gowdy and Ranking Member Cummings, thank you again for inviting me to testify today, and this concludes my testimony. I'm happy to take any questions.